Hello everybody, I am Baljit Haka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today we are going to discuss paper code 881. This is test series which is going on, online test series, and till now we have done 880 paper code. First question of this paper: if sine alpha secant 30 plus alpha is equal to 1, then the value of sine alpha plus cos 2a is how much? We have to find the value of this. Now, this is 1. This is given 1. If you put the value of alpha is equal to 30, then what will happen? Sine 30, it would be equal to 1 by 2, and secant 30 plus, because we have put the value of alpha 30, that is sine secant 60, and secant 60, then again you will find the value of 2, because secant 60 is opposite of cos, and cos 60 is 1 by 2, so it would become 2 by 1. So 1 by 2 and 2 by 1 is equal to 0. So in this way the equation can be balanced. So in this way we have seen that alpha is equal to 30 degree. Now we have to find the value of this sine alpha, that is sine 30, it is 1 by 2, and cos 2a. Cos 2a means 30 into 2, 60. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1. Answer is in this case A. Next question, question number 52. A tank can be filled by two pipes in 20 minute and 30 minute respectively. When the tank was empty, the two pipes were opened. After some time, the first pipe was stopped and tank was filled in 18 minutes. What does it mean? That the pipe 2 run 18 minutes. After how much time of the start was the first pipe stopped? Now this is the question. In this question, actually there are 4 options. However, in this slide it is not mentioned, but in fact A option is 5 minute, B option is 8 minute, and C option is 10 minute, and D option is 12 minute. Now this is the complete question. Now see, A and B, there are two tanks, A and B, 20 minutes and 30 minutes. Now let's take total capacity of the tank, 60 unit. So A, if you fill in 20 minutes 60 unit, then in 1 minute A will fill 3 unit. Similarly, because both are filling, 30 minutes B will fill 60 unit, then in 1 minute B will fill 2 unit. But here B is continuously running for 18 minutes. It means 18 into 2, 36 unit have been filled by B only. The balance is 60 minus 36, 24 unit, and 24 unit is filled by A, means role of A is 24 unit. So in 1 minute A fills 3 unit, it means A run for, you can say, 8 minute. A and B were running for 8 minutes. After that B started to run and A has stopped. B was continuously running and A stopped. So A stopped, you can say, in other words, A and B together worked for 8 minutes. Answer is in this case, this 8 minutes. B is the answer. Question number 53. A compound interest of a sum of money for 2 years at 4% per annum is rupees 2,448. Simple interest of the same sum of the money at the same rate of interest 2 years. For 2 years. Now we have to find the value of 2%. We have to find the value of a simple interest of the same sum of the money at the same rate of interest will be how much. And this is compound interest. And rate is 4% per annum. And 2. You can say in 2 years on 100 rupees, simple interest is 8 rupees. Simple interest is 8 rupees, because on 100 rupees for 1 year 4 rupees and for 2 years 8 rupees. But here the compound interest would be, you can use a successive percentage technique, 4 plus 4.16, you can say 8.16 rupees on 100 rupees will be the compound interest. So now you can find like this, 8.16 is the compound, then simple interest would be 8. If it is 1, then it would be 8.16, and if it is 2448, now in place of decimal you can write here 100. Now see, it will go by 3. In other words, you can say 2400 is the interest, simple interest. Answer is B. You can use successive technique in compound interest like this we have used. It will be more useful, and you need not to remember so many formulas also. Without formula, you can do compound interest, simple interest question like this. 54, question number. In the adjoining figure, find the value of QSR. QSR. This is very common question of SSC schedule. As we know, the quadrilateral will have some of angle of quadrilateral would be 360, and this is tangent. These are tangents. This is 90 degree and this is 90 degree. So in this quadrilateral, 180. It means these two angles would be of 180. If this is 50, then it would be 130, and if this is 130, then it is 65, because angle formed at the center is double as compared to angle formed at the circumference. Answer is B. Next question, question number 55. A candidate who scored 30% fails by 5 marks, while another candidate who scores 40% marks get 10 more than the minimum pass marks. The minimum marks required to pass are, now see, this is in fact window question, 30% and 40%. So 30% is you can say the difference of 10%. This is the difference of 10%. Now the 10% marks can create the value of a, you can say, if 5 marks minus and 10 marks plus. It means if 10% number marks are increased, then there will be a difference of a 15 marks. What is the interpretation of this? 10% number is equal to 15 marks, because if A gets 10% extra, then instead of failing, which he was failed by 5 marks, then he will get extra 10 marks. So with this 10%, difference has become 15% increment, 15%. 100% would be equal to 150 marks. 150 marks is means the total marks. Total marks, and you can say this examination will be of a maximum 150 marks. And 30% of this would be equal to 45, and if candidate gets another 5 marks, it means he will be pass. What does it mean? 30% is equal to 45 marks, and if he gets 45 marks, he will be failed by 5 marks. It means to get minimum pass mark, he has to score 50 marks. C, A is the answer. Question number 56. In an 1 kilometer race, A, B and C are the three participants. A can give B a start of 50 meter and C a start of 69 meter. The start which B can allow to C is how much? So remember this question. These are typical question, and if you understand this, these are very, very easy question. So this is 1 kilometer. Let's say this is 1 kilometer race. In a 1 kilometer race, A, B and C are three participants. A can give B a start of a 50 meter. In other words, you can say if A is traveling 1000 meter, then B will travel 950. B will travel a 950. In other words, If A gives start of 50 kilometer, then they will reach at the same time at the exact destination. And A can give B a start of 50 meter and C a start of 69. In other words, 1000 minus 69, that is, in other words, you can say 9:20:31, because 31 plus 69 you will get 1000. So when A will travel 1000 meter, B will travel 950 and C will travel 931. This is the according to the statement of the question. Now question is the start which B can allow to see in 1 kilometer race. It means if B travel 950, then C will travel 931. If B travel 1, then it will be 930 by 950. And if if B can afford a start of 19, you can write here 19, because 950 minus 931, that is, you write in this way, if B can afford it, the gap of 900 minus 931, that is 19 meter. If B gives a gap of a start of 19 meter on 950, then on 1000 meter, B will give start of 1000. You can say 20 meter start. On 1000, B can afford to give start to C 20 meter. On 950, it is 19 meter. So answer on 1000, that is B should be the answer. Question number 57. Ratio of the ages of a father and his son 10 years hence will be 5:3. While 10 years ago it was 3:1. In other words, 3x and 1x. This is 10 years ago. But from the current present scenario, after 10 years, you can say after this 20 years, the ratio would become 5:3. 5:3. This is the question. Now 9x is equal to 60 and 5x is equal to 100. 5x is equal to 100. 4x is equal to 40. X is equal to 10. In other words, the question is ratio of the age of son to that of father today is how much? Son and father, we have to tell son and father. Remember this. This is always important because this is asked opposite. Here it is given father and son age, but question is son to father age. Number one, this is has to be careful, otherwise you can do silly mistake. You have to remove silly mistake immediately. Now after 10 years, because after 10 years means it will be current, 30 plus 10, because value of x is 10, 30 years and 10 years, after 10 years, because after 10 years means currently it would be 40 and 20, 40 father 20, or you can another word say 2 father 1 son, so ratio is 1:2, answer is A. Question number 58. Sum of all the interior angle of a regular polygon is twice the sum of all its exterior angle. Number of side of the polygon we have to find. Number of side. So what can be the number of side? Now see the question. See X and Y. If you can say, if you want to use that word n in place before this, because you interior angle and sum of interior angle and exterior angle is 180. Interior angle and exterior angle is 80. When we multiply to both side by n, then it will be automatically cancelled. So just we have written x plus y, that is 180. But here it is given, the interior angle is twice. You can say here you can write in place of If this is, for example, we have taken interior angle, remember always interior angle will be more. So 3x is equal to 180, x is equal to 60. In other words, one angle, exterior angle is 60, then interior angle would be 120, total is 180. Now the question is number of side we have to find. 360 divided by exterior angle, which is 60. You can say number of sides 6. Number of sides 6, and you always remember, in case of hexagon, the interior angle is double as compared to exterior angle. 120 and 60 is the ratio. 120 exterior internal angle and interior angle, and 100 just 60 is exterior angle. So remember this also. Otherwise, you can also use one sum of exterior angle, that is 360, and sum of interior angle 2 and minus 4 into 90 is sum of interior angle. So you can also multiply 2, 360 by 2, you will get equal. You can then solve further. But I will suggest you use always in such kind of question, exterior angle plus interior angle is equal to 180. That is more easy, because calculation is less in this case. Question number 59. Question number 59. If x is a rational number and this expression given, which is equal to 2, then we have to find the sum of numerator and denominator of x. It means x is in fraction, which is indicated by x. Now open this bracket. This is a plus b cube minus a minus b cube, a plus b square, a minus b square. It means the formula used, which I have told. So when you open this bracket, you will get x3 plus 1 by 1 power 3, 3 x and x plus 1. And similarly in this case, you want to use bracket, you can use, otherwise you directly change the sign. X3 minus 1 power 3 minus 3 x and x minus 1. And in the denominator side, you will get, open this bracket, x square plus 1 plus 2x minus x square plus 1 minus 2x minus 2x. Now you can cancel this plus 1, and it will become, when you will open bracket, minus plus 2, and we open bracket, minus minus plus 4x, it will be equal to 4x. Similarly, if you open bracket, it will cancel to this. This is plus and minus minus plus, that is you can say 2. You can say 2. And here this is 3x square. In other words, you can write to this 3x square plus 3x. And here you can write 3x square, if you write minus 3x square and plus 3x. Goes minus and minus plus plus 3x, then you will have total, you will have, this will cancel, minus this is 3x plus, and then bracket is outside of this plus 3x, you can say minus, then it will cancel. You will get inside, after opening all the brackets, 6x square plus 2, that is 4x. So if you divide to both sides, because it is equal to 2 both sides, then you will have 3x square plus 1 divided by 4x and is equal to 1, if you divide both sides by 2. Then you can say 3x square, and it will go to this side 4x, but if you bring to this side, it will be minus 4x. And to minus 4x, you can write minus 3x minus x plus 1 is equal to 0, because this has become quadratic equation. That's why we have directly written like this. Now this 3x, x minus 3 and minus 1 and x minus 1, you can say 3x minus 1 and x minus 1 is equal to 0. X is equal to 1 and x is equal to 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 is in fraction. So numerator is 1, denominator is 3. 1 plus 3, that is 4. B should be the answer. What we have done in the question, we have done very simple things, that we have opened the bracket, and we opened the bracket, it will ultimately is equal to x is equal to 1 by 3 or x is equal to 1. Answer in this case is B. Question number 16. The ratio of the areas of incircle and circumcircle of a square. This is square. This is square. This is incircle. This is incircle and this is a circumcircle. And we have to find the ratio of area. This is very important keyword, ratio of area. So what will be the ratio of area? See, we have to know first the you can say the radius. Radius of first is incircle. Radius of incircle would be, for example, let's take this is 2. This is 2. Then radius would be half, that is 1. So pi r square. See, pi r square, I have written first this. Pi cancel both sides. R square, R we have taken here 1, because that if the side is 2 cm, then radius would be 1 square. And if the side is 2 cm, then diagonal would be 2 root 2. But half of diagonal, which is the radius of circumcircle, would be root 2. So root 2 square, root 2 square would be equal to 2. 1 is to 2, 2 would be the ratio of area. 1 is to 2. You can say 60, question number, answer is A. Now the next question is question number 61. What is this question? In this question, see, you rationalize this, and during the rationalization, the bigger term bring first. Bigger term is first. It means root 2 plus 1, and if you rationalize root 2 minus 1, then we will have root, multiply it both sides, root 2 minus 1 and divide by root 2 minus 1. So we will have root 2 minus 1, because root 2 square, that is 2, and square of 1, that is 1. So in denominator it will be 1, and in numerator it will be root 2 minus 1. Then similarly in other cases also, root 3 minus 2, root 4 minus 3, and then roots 100 minus 99. So it will be cancelled. For example, root 2 minus 1, root 3, and then it will cancel root 2, root 2, root 3, root 3, root 4 will cancel from to this term, and ultimately minus root 99 will also cancel. So ultimately you will have root 10, root 100, that is 10, and minus 1, 9 would be the answer. Ultimately you will get this minus 1, and this you will get plus. Root 100 would be equal to 10 minus 1, that is 9, should be the answer. Now question number 62. A and B together can complete a work in 8 days, and B and C together in 12 days. All of the three together can complete the work in 6 days. In how much time will A and C together complete the work? Very interesting question. A and B are doing in 8 days. B and C are doing in 12 days. ABC in 6 days. ABC in 6 days. Let us take total work as 24 unit. In one day, A plus B will do 3 unit. 24 divided by 8, 3 unit. B and C in 12 days, they will do 2 unit. And A plus B plus C in 24 unit in 6 days, they are doing. So in one day, they will do 4 unit. 3, 2 and 4. Now, what is the question? In how much time will A and C together complete the work? A and B, one day work is 3 unit, and ABC is 4 unit. So C, one day work is 1 unit. C, one day work is 1 unit. And what is the A? B and C, they are doing 2 unit, but ABC, they are doing 4 unit. It means 4 plus 2, that is 4 minus 2, that is 2 unit. A is doing 2 unit, because the difference is due to the A. So A is doing 2 unit, C is doing 1 unit. They will do both together in one day 3 unit. 3 3 unit. To complete 24 unit, they will take 8 days. They will take 8 days to complete the work. Question number 63. If the height of a cylinder is increased by 15%, if height of the cylinder is increased by 15% and the radius of the base is decreased by 10%, what is the surface area change? Curved surface area of the cylinder. What is curved surface area? 2 pi r h and 2 pi r h this side. Here 2 pi cancel. So r you can write here like this, r h is equal to r 1 and h 1. And let's take r is 20 and h is also 20. For simplicity purpose we have taken 20 20. Height is increased by 15%. In other words, 15% of 20, that is 3. So 23 is the height, and radius of the base decreased by 10%. 10% means 10% of 20, that is 2. So radius would become now 18. This is equal to 400 of 20 into 20, 400, and this is equal to 18 into 3, that is 54. Carry 5. That is 414. So 414 and air is 400. Earlier the cut surface area is, for example, if 400, then the new area would be 414. It will go by 200, then 207, or you can say 3.5. on 200 the increase is 7 unit. On 100 it will be 3.5. so 3.5 increases the area. Answer is B. Next question. Question number 64. Two trains are moving on two parallel tracks but in opposite direction. A person sitting in the train moving at the speed of 80 km passes the second train in 18 seconds. If the length of the second train is 1000 meter, its speed is how much? You have to find the speed. Two trains are moving on two parallel tracks but in opposite direction, you can say this side and this side. One person sitting in the train, it means the person sitting in the train, for example this train, at the speed of 80 km per hour, this training is 80 km per hour, passes the second train in 18 seconds. If the length of the second train is, that is 1000, so 1000 is the total distance, and we are not taking the length of first train. Why? Because the person is sitting in this train, and when the person is sitting, it means when this train will cross, second train will cross, then this train is crossing this person only, not the entire train. So we have just taken the length of second train. 1000 meters is the length of second train, and you can say x is the speed of the second train, and 80 is the speed of first train. 80 is the speed of a first train. Then distance divided by total speed, this is relative speed, and which is in opposite direction, that's why we have added, and that will take 80 seconds. In other words, 80 divided by 3600, this is hour. So it will be equal to, you can say 80 divided by 360, 45,000 is equal to 80 plus x. 80 plus x. So, sorry, this is 80, not 80, not 80. So let's write this again. 1000 divided by 80 plus x, and 18 divided by, we have converted now into hours. So it will be equal to, you can say 1 by 200, and 1 by 200 would be And this is 1000 meter. So instead of meter, you can take 1 kilometer, because everything we are taking in, everything we are taking in kilometer per hour. So it will be 200 is equal to 80 plus x. In other words, x is equal to 120. 120 b is the answer. In this question, what we have done? In place of 1000 meter, you can write here 1 kilometer. So 180 plus x, which is the total speed of both the train, and this is the distance, that is 1 kilometer, and here 18 second, so we have converted into hours, that's why we have divided to by 3600, because in 1 hour there are 3600 seconds. So distance divided by speed, that is time. Time is 1 by 200 hours. We can find now the value of x. X is the speed of the second train. Answer is B. Next question, question number 65. The angle of a elevation of the top of a tower from two points A and B lying. Question number 65. In this question, the angle of elevation of the top of a tower from two points A and B lying on the horizontal through the foot of the tower are respectively 15 degree and 30 degree. If A and B are on the same side of the tower and AB is equal to 48 meter, the height of the tower we have to tell. What is the question? Let's look into from this diagram. This is 15 degree, this is 30 degree, A and B difference is 48, and we have to find the value of S, that is the height of the tower. So tangent 15 degree is equal to 2 minus root 3. This is always remember, or you can say quote, which is opposite of this would be quote 15 is equal to 2 plus root 3. This you have to remember. Now, what was the shortcut method of this? I have told many times, and because I told you the height and distance question, this is very important short trick method, that is D is equal to H quote 1 and quote 2. What is quote 1? This is higher value of a theta. Now D is the distance, this is 48. H, we have to find the value of H. Quote lower value, higher value is 2 plus root 3. Minus quote theta, that is you can say quote 30, which is minus root 3. Minus root 3, minus root 3 cancel. Root 3 cancel. Value now 48 is equal to 2H. You can say value of H would be 24. Answer is 24 in this question. B is the answer. So this is very easy if you use this short trick method and you remember this, because it is frequently used and highly useful. Question number 66. A person can row 7 plus 1 by 2, you can say 7.5 km an hour in still water. He find that this is still water, the speed is 7.5 km, and he find that it takes him twice as long as to row up as to row down the river. The speed of the stream we have to find. In other words, you can say 7.5 plus x, this is stream of water, speed of stream is x we have taken, because we have to find the value of speed of stream also, because it means we have to find the value of x, and this is still water speed. So 7.5, this is downstream stream, and upstream is minus x. So it will take two times, you can say you multiply it by 2, then it will be equal to, both the expression is balanced now. In other words, the upstream speed is half of a downstream speed. If you multiply it by 2, then it will be equal to downstream. So 7.5 plus x is equal to 15 minus 2x. 3x is equal to 15 minus 7.5, that is 7.5. Value of x is 2.5. C is the answer. Question number 67. Average of 5 number is 140. If one number is excluded, the average of the remaining 4 is 130. Excluded number we have to tell. Average of 5 number, you can say 140 into 5, 700. And if one number is excluded, it means four number we have to tell, and the average is become 130. So you can say 520 is the average. 180 is the value of a fifth number, means excluded number. You can say 180 C is the answer in this case. Question number 68. A man has in all rupees 640 in the denomination of 1 rupee, 5 rupee and 10 rupee notes. The number of each type of notes are equal. What is the total number of notes he has? It means total rupees is 640 and the combination is 1 rupee note, 5 rupee note and 10 rupee note. 10 rupee note. Number of each type of notes are equal. It means notes are equal. What is the total number of notes he has? So if he has 3 note and the ratio is same, 3 note, then 10 plus 5 15 plus 1 16. When he has 3 notes, then total value is 16 rupees. You can say 16 rupees is equal to 3 notes, then 1 rupee is equal to 3 by 16 and 640 is equal to 120 notes. So total number of notes he has 120, because from 16 rupees he has 3 notes. Question number 69. Area of equilateral triangle inscribed in a circle and inscribed in a circle is 4 root 3. Inscribed in a circle, equilateral triangle. This is area of the circle we have to find. We have to find the area of the circle. Now root 3 by 2 A is equal to H. H is the height. And if we know 2 by 3 of the height, then it means we know the radius. Then we can find, if we know the radius, why 2 by, this is 2, this is 1. This is 2, this is 1, because this is centroid and this will, the centroid is, you can say, is the point where you can draw circumcircle. So this is 2, this is 1, it means height, 2 by 3 of height is the radius of a circumcircle. So root 3 by 2 A is equal to H, and 2 by 3, first you know the area of equilateral triangle. So root 3 by 4 A square is equal to 4 root 3, this is given. So 4 root 3 and 4 root 3 cancel, A square is equal to 16, A is equal to 4. So A is equal to 4, you can say, if A is 4, then it will cancel to root 3, in other words, root 2 by 2 root 3, because here if it is 4, then 2 root 3 is equal to H. But we want to know the, what is the value of 2 by 3 H. So 2 by 3 H will be equal to 2 by 3 into 2 root 3, 4 root 3. This is the value of a 2 by 3 H, which is equal to R. In other words, pi R square, means pi R square would be equal to 4 root 3 and 4 3 root 3. This is equal to 3 into 3, 9. Pi 9, here you can write. And root 3 into root 3, 3. 4 into 4, 16. 16 into 3, you can say 48. 48. So it will also cancel by 3. Then 16 by 3 pi, 16 by 3 pi A is the answer. So what we have done in this question is that first we have to find the value of R. Now R is 2 by 3 of H, and H is equal to root 3 by 2, A is equal to H. And A we can find from the area of equilateral triangle, which is equal to root 3 by 4 A square, which is given 4 root 3. If we know the R, then we can know the H. If we know, we can know the H, then we can know the R. And if we know the R, then we can know the area of a circle. So in this way we can find this question. Question number 17. An interval of 3 hours 40 minutes is wrongly estimated as 3 hour 45.5. The error percentage, it means there is an error of a 5 minute 5. You can say 11 by 2 minute error. 11 by 2 minute on 3 hours 40 minute. 11 by 2 minute error is on 3 hours. That is 180 plus 4, 220 minute. 220 minute error, or in other words, 11 point, you can write 5.5 divided by 2.220 into 100. We have to tell the percentage. So in place of decimal, you can write 10. Then it will be equal to, it will cancel like this, and 5 by 2%. 5 by 2% means 2.5%. 5 by 2 means 2.5% is the error. Question number 71. The greatest number by which 1657 and 2037 are divided to give remainder 6 and 5 respectively. It means we have to find the value of greatest number, and from that number if we divide to this, the remainder is 6. It means if I subtract minus 6 from, then from the greatest number this number will be divided. You can say 165 number is the number to which the greatest number will divide. There will be no remainder. And similarly, 2037, the greatest number will divide when, if I subtract minus 2, that is 2032. 2037 minus 5, that is 2032, is the number which divided by greatest number, and there will be no remainder. So what is the greatest number? Then we can take HCF of these two. And what, how to find the HCF? You can find by division method. Like this, 1651, and it will go 1651 to 18, and you will know 963, and then again you divide to 1651. It will be continuously divided until unless you have zero remainder. So it will be, you can say it will go by 4, then it will be here 127. So you can divide, it will be divided by 381 is divided by 123. It means 127 is the HCF. Answer is A. A is the greatest number. That is 127 is the greatest number that will divide both these two numbers, and there will be no remainder. If these numbers are divided, then remainder will be respectively 6 and 5. Question number 72. Total cost price of two watches is rupees 850. One is sold at a profit of 16% and other at a loss of 12%. There is no loss or gain in the whole transaction. The cost price of the watch on which the shopkeeper gains would be how much? Now 16% profit and loss is 12%. You can solve this question by allegation technique, and there is no profit and loss. You can say 0 is on the mix. So difference here is 12 and here is 16. There is no value or issue of plus minus because this is indicating for ratio only. 3 to 4 is the ratio. 3, that is 16% case, and 12, that is 4% case, because this will come to this and this will come to this. So 3 is to 4 is the total price ratio. So you can say price of this would be 3 by 7. If 7 is the total price, then roll is roll of a, you can say 16% good is 3. On 840 it would be 120 into 3, that is 360 is the answer. So such kind of question you can also throw by allegation technique. 16 minus 12, then it would be, because there is no profit loss, then you can put here 0 and the ratio become 3 is to 4. So it means the total cost can be divided into 3 is to 4 ratio, means 3 profit percentage and 12 loss percentage, 4 loss percentage. Question number 73. We have to find the value of this expression. Sin theta, that is 1 by 2. Tangent, that is 1. Cos is equal to sin 30, that is 1 by 2. And we have to find the value of this is equal to 1. This is the question that sometimes you will find, and be careful, because you can do such in such kind of questions silly mistakes. So remember this. Also, answer is A, C. Question number 74. In a regular polygon, the exterior and interior angle are in the ratio 1:4. The number of sides of the polygon. See, x plus 4x, interior angle, exterior angle, sum is always equal to 180. And 5x is equal to 180, x is equal to 36. 180 divided by 5, that is 36. If this is exterior angle, because exterior angle is always less as compared to interior angle in case of a regular polygon. So 360 is the total angle, and 36 is the one angle. It means number of sides is 10. Answer is A. Total angle divided by exterior angle, that is number of sides. That is answer is A. Next question, question number 75. And what is this question? In this question, it is given a shopkeeper gives 12% additional discount after giving an initial discount of 20% on the marked price of the radio. If the sale price of the radio is 704, then marked price would be how much? So this is the selling price after giving two discount. It means marked price is more, and marked price is more means 100 divided by 80 and 100 divided by 88. This is the marked price. This is the marked price. 88, because why 88? 100 minus 12, that is 88, 100 minus 20, that is 80. So you can say it will go by 11. $1,000 is the marked price. Answer is D. Such kind of question you can solve like this. This is 1,000. So in this way we have solved all the questions, all 75 questions from 51. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.